गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः वी आर इन ज्ञानेश्वरी चैप्टर 10 वर्स नंबर 15 एंड लास्ट टाइम वी सॉ इन द 14th वर्स द लॉर्ड सेड सर्वमेतद्रुतं मन्ये यन्मां वदसि केशव नहि ते भगवन् व्यक्तिं विदुर्देवानदानवाः ऑल दिस व्हाट यू से ओ केशव आई बिलीव टू बी ट्रू Neither the gods nor the demons know your true manifestations, O Lord. Meaning, just to recap a little bit, and that is, the Arjuna is has begun his journey of transformation, and transformation only comes about when we are faced with difficulty. Otherwise, when everything is going hunky-dory, nobody changes. Only when there is friction, only when there is challenge, when there is depression, then that window of opportunity opens up. Otherwise it doesn't, because you are comfortable. Only in discomfort transformation is possible. So intelligent person is he who does not wait for difficulties to come. He creates difficulties in his life. So that is ever uncomfortable. In other words, that whenever we don't have to wait for difficulties, but when we look at the world, everything is going fine. You find out that is this all that there is life about, or is there something else to be done? Is there a higher purpose to be gained or lived for? And that itself will make you think about something more than what is comfortable. Human being is anyway from inside is pushed to do more and more and more and more. If he doesn't gather his energies and put them in the right direction, they will go in the wrong direction, negative direction. And that is how it is. You cannot say, no. It is, if you leave the mind alone, it will automatically go towards the world. It will automatically go towards anger, greed, jealousy, envy, hypocrisy, and ego. The sick shat vikar. Automatically it will start happening. So we have to, again and again, we have to catch it. Like we train a horse. It is wild in the beginning. And then you have to train it, and then you can ride it. Fire, if left alone, it will burn the whole house. But man is intelligent. He has trained the fire. Now he uses it for his benefit. Similarly is the mind. Use it for your benefit. Similar is the body. Use it for your benefit. See? Concepts, use them for your benefit. Don't get caught up in some idea or concept that so many people, they may be. We want the concept which is the father of all concepts, and that is the Lord. And here he says, Arjuna has studied all this, and he's going through the transformation in the middle of the battlefield, and that battlefield is right now here between us. It is between husband and wife, it is between son and daughter, mother, siblings. But as we come closer and closer, it is within our mind. Because mind is nothing but pairs of opposites. Likes, dislikes, joy, sorrow, comfort, discomfort, hunger, thirst. Everything has opposite. Man, woman, peace, no peace, reality, non-reality. Everything, all these ideas are only in your mind. See? So that is the battlefield where Arjuna is, between the good forces and the bad forces. So he who is an intelligent person, who finds and keeps himself in the middle of all these two opposing forces, every moment of his existence. Do you mean that we are at war all the time? Of course you are. संघर्ष ही तो जीवन का एक एकमात्र वो है, क्या कहते हैं, सत्य. संघर्ष मीन्स व्हाट डू यू कॉल संघर्ष इन इंग्लिश?
कन्फ्रंटेशन.
एंड दैट कन्फ्रंटेशन इज नॉट अबाउट यू, द वर्ल्ड इज नॉट अबाउट यू, द वर्ल्ड इज फॉर द माइंड. द कन्फ्रंटेशन इज फॉर द माइंड, द पीस इज फॉर द माइंड, नो पीस इज फॉर द माइंड, यू आर अदर देन द माइंड. See, and that because Arjuna surrendered to Krishna, Krishna took the chariot in the middle of the two armies and said, here, this is what you have to do now. And he looked this side and he looked that side. We also look at both sides in our mind all the time. And we get confused. Should I eat this? Should I eat one more chapati or should I eat one less? Should I eat chapati, rice today? No, but then again, achha, you force me, I'll take it. See? We give in. So which means, he gave in to likes or to dislikes. But Arjuna did not give in to good side or bad side. He came to a conclusion, oh Lord, I do not know what is good for me. You decide and tell me what is best for me. And why you should tell me? Because I am your disciple, I am your devotee. Put yourself into this position every moment of your existence. Rather than you take decisions about life, allow him to take. How will you come to know that he's taking? It will be an unstoppable force coming out of you. You will just know it intuitively. You will just know that it is right. And initially it is a bit of a rocky road. But after some time, you will become comfortable with it. You will come to know what is the desire of the mind and what is the intuitive mind. You listen to that inner voice. Try in small things. Don't start straight away with big things. So Arjuna has surrendered to the Lord, and as over the last few chapters, he has unfolded himself. Because he has offered himself to the Lord, Lord says, now that you have offered yourself to me, now it is my responsibility. But what I want from you, a total commitment to me. You know me as only a brother, a cousin brother. You only know me as your charioteer. Some people must have told you I got great powers, but nobody knows me. So here Arjuna is telling, Lord, whatever people told, whatever great people told, saints and sages told about you, the scriptures talk about you, all that I believe it now. I believe it now. And I also come to this conclusion that the scriptures cannot talk about you, the saints and sages don't know you, and not only that, even the good and the bad people also do not know you. Why? How can an effect come to know the cause? How can an effect come to know the cause? A teeny weeny ice block, cube of ice, which gets frozen because of the circumstances at North Pole. The water is infinite and it gets frozen. And this fellow gets an identity. I am someone. Don't mess with me. How can he know the immensity of his own nature? That ice cube is essentially water. Water is necessarily infinite in its nature, isn't it? It's not bound by anything. And that cube of ice is trying to work out what this ocean is or the water is, what infinity is. Cannot. You have to surrender. In that surrender, the ice cube will melt. The individuality will melt away. Melting of individuality is equal to what? It's equal to surrendering at the feet of the Lord. What is its manifestation, symptom in your life? You are not affected by the likes and dislikes, by the joys and sorrows, by the hunger and thirst, by peace or no peace, by waking or deep sleep. Nothing affects you anymore. Why? Your relationship is not with the world anymore. Once you have applied yourself to the Lord, to the best of your capacity, with faith, then Lord is the reality for you. Waking and sleeping is not reality. Being a husband and wife is not a reality. Being a father and a child is not a reality. It's a total different... Then this thought will not come to such a person. Oh, I am applying so much to the Lord, but what do I do if I can't sleep tonight? These people have told us. They are sleeping at night and they are continuously the mantra is going on. And then they feel that next morning they are going to be incapable of carrying out the daily activity. Because you have to go to work, you have to take the children to school, you have to do this, you have to do, running around everywhere. But whole night I have not slept. And yet they are able to do it. So this thinking that because I remember, because the mantra was going on for the whole night, where has this doubt come about the world now? Let him handle. See? So here Arjuna has come to this conclusion that neither the gods nor the demons know your manifestation. In the previous verse, neither the saints and sages nor the Narada, Narad Muni, Asita, Devala, Vyasa, all of the people, and also the scriptures, they cannot know you. Scriptures themselves say that we cannot tell you who the Lord is. But we'll attempt. And then they say Sahasra Shirsha Purusha Sahasraksha Sahasrapad. They say the Rudram, first few verses, beginning of the Rudram, it's about what the Lord is, what his scope of infinite manifestation is. And there are different mantras. Brahman is infinite. What? And you say, yes, I understand infinite. Nobody has ever understood what infinity is. How come you have understood infinity? You are intelligent. And we still nod. Nobody has ever experienced infinity. Infinity is not a concept which the mind can even fathom. He only knows with no beginning and no end. But what is that beginning with no beginning and no end? He doesn't know. He can just appreciate. Hold on, stay there. Don't come to a conclusion. So scriptures say, how can, we are limited. We can only use words to express. How can you express limited words to describe the infinite Paramatma? You cannot. And the whole journey is that Paramatma, essentially you are. Everyone is that essentially. He's manifesting in and through you, inside and outside of you. But do we have the vision? As long as we think of the world, we can never have that transformation in the vision. But if we are surrendered to the Lord, without looking back at the world, then it is possible. And in the 11th chapter, that vision will be presented to Arjuna in the next chapter. So here, coming to the, which verse? 15th verse.
Swayamevatmanatmanam vetham tvam purushottama bhuta bhavana bhutesha deva deva jagatpate.
In the 15th verse he says, you yourself alone know yourself, O Supreme Person, the cause and the Lord of creatures, O God of gods, the ruler of the world. Swayam eva atmana atmanam. Remember, in the 6th chapter, Uddhared atmana atmanam, natmanam avasadhayet. In the 6th chapter of Bhagavad Gita, this verse had come. Uddharet atmana atmanam. Raise yourself by yourself in yourself. This was the instruction given. For what? Raise yourself in yourself, by yourself, for yourself. So that you come to know that you are essentially infinite. You are of the image of the Lord, essentially. And what have you taken yourself to be the image of yourself? This caricature, a little bit. And you are infinite. See? So the same words are being used. Swayamevatmanatmanam. Hello, how are you? I'm better than you. Huh? So Arjuna is saying, there he understood. But here it's a journey of surrender. No ownership is taken of anything. So he's saying, O Lord, you are the knower of yourself. I can never come to know you. Can the Jiva ever come to know the Paramatma? Is it possible? This question we put last week. Can the wave ever come to know the waters? No, the wave as an entity, the form may be there, but as a person who's holding on and identified with the form, the jivahood, the individuality must vanish in order for the totality or the infinity to express. When you are touching a wave, you are touching the ocean. And at the same time, you are touching the water. If you are touching the wave, tasting the wave, feeling the wave, then if you are touching the water, you are feeling the water, tasting the water, then why are you calling it a wave? A question to be pondered upon. Because our attention is on the name and form. That is why. We touch the ornament, we feel the ornament, we taste the ornament, but actually we are tasting the gold, touching the gold, feeling the gold, but we call it ornament. This is how we have hoodwinked ourselves. We got caught in our own trap. Have you seen Matrix? He saw just now. You saw it that day? Postponed till I come back, is it? The whole gang will come, or we can see it here. Have you seen? You have seen? You guys have seen? Beautiful spiritual journey of Neo. That's how he is expanding over the three movies. He realizes, without doing, absolutely effortlessly. But it's all in the mind. Till that itch is there that I have to do something, the opposite force is increasing in the same manner as he is growing spiritually. But in the end, the final juncture, he lets go. And in that letting go, because his attention is on the ultimate and the supreme light, on his essence. And then, without his doing anything, every negative Mr. Smith becomes of the nature of light. Without him doing anything. This is the transformation of vision that we are talking about. So here, O Lord, you know, you alone know yourself. For us, we alone know ourselves, but we are foolishly believing ourselves to be someone else, an individual. But if you analyze your experience, any experience you take, there has never been a moment in your life when you have been an individual. Not one experience of your life stands the test of analysis. Not one. You say, I am a waker, I am a dreamer, I am a deep sleeper. How do you know it? You must be someone separate to these three, therefore you can talk about it. I can talk about you because you are separate to me. I can talk about my body because it is separate to me. Isn't it? Only that person you can. Then if I talk about you, this is the way I'm just teasing your brain at the moment. If you are all separate to me and I talk about you, because I'm talking about you, have I become you? Is it possible I can become you? I cannot become you. I am separate to you, therefore I can comment on you, isn't it? Now see, come closer from far away, now come to yourself. Do you talk about the body? Do you comment on the body? Do you look at the shape of the body? Do you train the body? Do you exercise the body? Do you feed the body? Is it? You do it, isn't it? You see the body. I can, just like I'm seeing you, I'm seeing the body. That means I am someone other than the body. Then why I think that I am the body and move around in this world? I can only talk about something that which I am not. Right? You can only give words to that. So I talk about my body, I talk about my breath, I talk about my emotions, I can talk about my beliefs and convictions. Nothing of all these are me. They belong to the Prakriti. So stop commenting about it. Just think of the Lord. Why did we come to the class? I have taken only one analysis. If I take any other, if you keep coming, these things keep coming, right? So, here Jnaneshwar Maharaj says, the verse, he says, O Supreme Person, you are the ultimate cause of the whole creation. Ocean is the cause of all the waves. Gold is the cause of all the ornaments. The Lord is the cause of the entire creation. And the Lord of creatures, O God of gods, the ruler of the world, O Lord, you are the Purushottama. You are the ruler. You have manifested the whole world out of you. And yet you are separate from the world. How is this possible? This is the question of the Arjuna. This is should be our question. That am I the one I create? I, because of me, the thoughts come in the mind. Then who am I? Because I know the thoughts came and went. I know yesterday came and went. I know the emotions come and go. But when the emotions come, I become emotional. When the sentiments come, I become sentimental. But I have never been. This is the unhealthy identification that has somehow cropped up. Somehow it has cropped. And wherever this identification crops up, in Matrix, Neo suffers. Correct? Neo suffers. Every time identification comes, he suffers. Then he goes exploring himself and finding something more about himself. Till in the end, he stops identifying even with him, not only with Mr. Smith, but also with himself. How do you stop identifying with yourself? What were the two names, huh? Neo and Mr. Henderson. So which is the real one? Henderson. One of the names. Henderson is the real one. And he is himself taking himself to be Neo. But he knows that this is only a dream. I am someone else. And because he is thinking about his original, so when we are studying Bhagavad Gita, we are thinking about our original. When we are studying, thinking about the Lord or listening to the words of the Lord, Lord is our soul, Lord is our essence. So we are focusing on the real, not the unreal. So Jnaneshwar Maharaj says, Heth apule vadhapan jaise, apanasi zhanize akashe, कामी ये तुली घनवट ऐसे पृथ्वी ची जाने तैसा आपुलिये सर्वशक्ति तुझतु ची जानसी लक्ष्मीपति ये रवेदाधिकमति सिरवती मिरवती वाया हागा मनाते मागा सांडावे पवनाते वावी सवा मवावे आदिशून्यतरो निजावे के उते वाही
तैसे हे तुझे जानने आहे, म्हणनी कोणाही ठाऊके नाहे, आता तुझे ज्ञान होये तुझची जोगे। जी जी आपण याते तूची जाणसी, आणि कांते आणि का ते सांगावयाही समर्थ होसी, तरी आता एक वेळ धाम पुसी, अतीची निडळीचा।
सो ही सेज हियर दॅट जस्ट ॲज द स्काय नोज इट्स ओन एक्सपॅन्स ऑर द अर्थ नोज इट्स ओन मास, सो यू युअर सेल्फ ओ लॉर्ड ऑफ लक्ष्मी नो युअर इन्फायनाईट पॉवर। द वेदाज, द शास्त्रास, द पुराणाज बोस्ट इन वेन ऑफ देअर नॉलेज ऑफ यू, ओ लॉर्ड हू कॅन सरपास द माइंड इन स्पीड, हाऊ कॅन एनी वन क्लास्प द विंड इन हिज आर्म्स, हाऊ कॅन एनी वन स्विम अक्रॉस द रिवर ऑफ माया विद अनएडेड आर्म्स। इट इज इक्वली हार्ड टू नो युअर यू, indeed no mortal can do so without help, you alone know your real self, and you yourself are capable of making others by your spoken word to realize you. Nobody is capable of knowing the Lord of his own accord. Why? Individuality is intact, and that is why yoga, pranayama, etc. for some extent it is okay, but if you are a seeker you must give it up. Give it up means go beyond it. I'm not saying give it up, you must do it because it's good, the body needs to be fit, but it is not the way that you reach the truth. In what sense it is not the way? Don't misunderstand. When you focus on the asana, by doing asanas you cannot know the reality. If you are focused only on pranayama, you cannot know the reality. If you are only focused on the mind or japa, you cannot come to know the reality. If you are only focused on logic, you cannot come to know reality. If you are only focused on nirvikalpa samadhi, you cannot come to know the reality. Nirvikalpa samadhi is not realization. It is only one of the states. So one must be clear what is their destination, what is their goal, why are they doing yoga asanas, why are they doing pranayama, why are we doing the japa sadhana, why are we studying the scriptures, why are we studying the scriptures, why have you come? To please me? No. Why? No, nobody can get knowledge. We have come to, I'm just teasing, we have come to reformat ourselves. The system is corrupted. Going to satsang is reformatting your hard disk, reformatting your mind. And once you reformat it, now, and after reformatting, as you are reformatting, so you are undoing the old data. See, the brain is, if you take, without brain, mind cannot function. But brain has one quality. You know what it is? What is the quality of brain? Its cells never die. By age 28, your brain is fully developed. After that, it remains. It never becomes less, it never becomes more. The brain cells never die. All other cells in your body, they die. Isn't it? Brain cells don't die. Second rule. The brain is a network, a neural network. You understand neural network? Neurons are firing. Prang, prung, prang, prung. But the intensity of their firing depends upon your intensity of emotion, your intensity of involvement with a particular experience. So if this child suddenly cries from that other room, her neurons have fired fully for the child. Immediately she'll get up and go there. It's automatic, default. nothing is going to happen to me, nothing is going to happen to them, she will get up. So once a neural path is created within the brain cells and that becomes your experience, a default experience, it cannot be undone. This is one problem with the brain. Whatever you put in, feed it, it remains there. Now what can be done then? What is reformatting here in this case? In in a hard disk, you empty the disk, isn't it? But you, here you cannot empty the disk. Then what can you do then? If the old memories and the old neural networks of whatever emotions, responses, reactions, instincts, everything is already stored in there and some of the wrong things are stored, how do you change it? You have to create new networks within your brain, within your mind. So when we interact with Bhagavad Gita, when we interact with satsang, when we interact with the Lord in our mind, do it with such intense love for Him that it overrides all other neural paths. Then they become important. So once this new system starts, because brain is the same, but so it will be directly proportional to your devotion and surrender to the Lord. This is what Arjuna is doing in his whole, this whole discourse. This is what he is doing. He did not do yoga, he did not do pranayam, he did not do karma yoga, he is not going to do devotion also. And yet everything is happening. Yet everything is happening. You mean to say that meditation is possible only when you sit on the floor in a lotus position? Then Ramana Maharishi is a caricature of a meditator. He lies down and sits in meditation. He walks around and he is in meditation. No, remove the wrong concepts from your mind. Without studying scriptures, we cannot come to know the divine. Wrong conclusion. Ramana Maharishi never studied any scriptures. He went. Satya Sai Baba never studied any scriptures. He came to know. Ammachi never studied scriptures. She came to know. Afterwards, they came to know. They studied. Ramana Maharishi studied Sanskrit, Tamil afterwards. Not before realization, after realization. Satya Sai Baba never did anything, yet from his mouth. Because all knowledge is not in the books, the knowledge is in the Akash. Which Akash? Not the outside Akash, in the Chitta Akash, meaning the mental space. You can just catch it like this, like Neo does. He thinks, I want to learn how to drive a helicopter. Sure, he starts. Same way here. In the olden times, if you see some, nowadays so many serials are coming, when the teacher tells the student, Parshuram tells the Karna, or Indradev gives the Shakti Astra to Karna because he has taken the Kavach and Kundal, so he feels bad and he says, I give you a Shakti. He did not make him do any exercise. All he said was the word. And more important than that, was the disposition of the student who is receiving. He is receiving it without doubt. Arjuna went to Indra, he went to Lord Shiva, he also gave him all the weapons, etc. It was not, now you have to practice and do this. All practice he did in Guru Dronacharya's ashram. But all the powerful weapons, he got it without any practice. He got it out of surrender. See, learn this about life. Life, you cannot make things happen because you want them to change. It is by His grace. The abilities, the capabilities, the potential, the strength. Never take ownership of it. Creativity, Don't take ownership of it. Give it, offer it to the Lord. You made me angry. It's your problem, not my problem. Story over. I'm sleepy. In certain, you're doing yoga, or you know, when you do yoga nidra, sleep comes. Oh my God, again I slept today after the class. I had to be aware. Sleeping. Don't take ownership. Offer it. Why did you make me sleep? Why did you make the mind sleep? It's your problem, not my problem. Next time, make me awake. Keep me awake. Keep this mind awake. I want to be aware that sleep is coming because we are not fully involved with the Lord yet. We still think that we can do it. Yoga is all about we can do it. Logic is all about I can understand. Devotion is all about, for majority people, I chanted so many parayans. So many times I chanted Lalita Sahasranam, so many times I chanted Vishnu Sahasranam, so many times I did this. It's all an ego trip, man. It's all an ego trip. Then what is required? Should we stop? No, don't stop. Change your attitude while doing it. Don't try to achieve something by chanting. Instead, have a disposition that while chanting, the Lord must reveal himself to me. The Lalita Devi must reveal herself. I must feel her presence in and around me at that very moment. Not afterwards, while you are chanting. Then automatically the way you chant, the way you speak, your disposition, everything will change. You will be hyper alert. But if you are doing mechanically, after some time you will get tired. Bahut ho gaya yaar. Today I don't know why it took so long. It seemed it was very long, isn't it? When you are enjoying, the day seems short. When you are not enjoying, you're bored. Even 1 hour seems like as if it's a day, isn't it? So Naneshwar Maharaj says, हे आई किले की भूत भावना त्रिभुवन गज पंचानना सकल देव देवतार्चना जगन्नायका जरी थोरी तुझी पाहत आहो तरी पासी उभे ठाका वया ही योग्य ना हो या शोच्यता जरी विनवु बिहो तरी आन उपायो नाही भरले समुद्र सरिता चहू कड़े परिते वापियासी कोरडे काजय मेघवनी ये थे काजय मेघवनी थेम्बुटा पड़े तय पाणी की तया तय श्रे श्री गुरु सर्वत्र आथी परिकृष्णा आम्हा तूची गति हे असो मज प्रति विभूति सांगे. Here he says, O you, the creator of the universe, O you, Lord, the lion who destroys the elephant of worldly existence, O you, Lord, the providence, who is the only object of worship of to all gods, do you hear me? Arjuna is saying, knowing your glory as I do, I am not even fit to stand in your presence. If I were to flinch now because of my unworthiness from beseeching a favor from you, then there is no other way to attain you. Even if the rivers and the seas are overfull in all ways, of what use are they to the Chataka birds? It is only when the clouds shed a few drops of water, they will have water to drink. In the same way, O Lord Krishna, although there are many masters in the world, you are all in all to us. This is enough. Now tell me about your manifestations. Chataka bird is a mythological bird. They are like the goose, and they drink only the water which is falling from the sky, not anything else. And that too also on a full moon day. So there may be so many water bodies ocean, rivers, lakes, wells, etc., etc. But that does not satiate the thirst of the Chataka bird. Similarly, there may be teachers, Mahatmas, realized masters, but we see them as what? We see them as what?
As a person,
isn't it? We see them as a form. And we are never able to bring ourselves to see that one form representing the infinite. We are not able to see that. We can't see one ornament representing the entire gold. We can't see the one pot of mud representing the entire earth. This is our fault of our vision. So he says, no. Just like that Chataka bird can drink only when the water falls from the sky, similarly, I am also like that. I want those, all those masters are there, all those great masters are there, but they are like the waters of the ocean and the river and the lake. I want a few drops of water. From where? From your mouth. Only they can satiate me. You see, when you come across, when you go to temples, I've been to wherever in any part of the world, you must have come across, sometimes people are doing bhajan, sometimes people are in India, though you will see them sitting in meditation, and a divine smile on their face. Why? They are in communion with the Lord. At that moment, nothing else matters. Nothing else matters. Eyes automatically close. If they don't close, also okay. Just like when you go to sleep, who you are as a body, who are you, a husband, wife, daughter, brother, sister, does not matter once you go to sleep. Similarly, sleep is an ignorant way of coming to the source, because you experience bliss there. Isn't it? Sleep is the... Otherwise, if we don't experience that bliss, next day we will not be fresh. We have to go back to the source. But between me and the source, there is a black veil of ignorance. But when I take the name of the Lord, and as a result of the surrender, because of the melting of my personality, because of the faith with which I am taking the Lord's name, this individual keeps coming closer and closer and closer. And because he has not gone to sleep, he is keeping himself awake. That veil of ignorance can be worked upon. And as he comes close, initially he puts self-effort. When he comes close, then he realizes, my self-efforts can never remove the veil of ignorance or Maya. So he calls out to the Lord. And in that, because who is Lord? He is Mayapati. He is the master of the world. He is the master of his wife. He is not influenced by what he has created. We are influenced by what we have created. Who is the parents? You are the parent? The child makes us run around. Who is the boss? Parents. Who is running around? Parents. Who is the creator? Parents. Who should be running around? The creator should not be running around. The creator should not lose the plot. The Lord never loses the plot. He understands the whole creation has come out of my potentiality, the Maya, and this potentiality is ever under my control. But we, as individual, we come together, we invoke our potentiality, we get married, we have children, we have houses, we have investments, this, that, everything. And unlike the Lord, we start getting dictated by what we have created for ourselves, isn't it? We start getting dictated by it. The one who gets dictated by the world is called an individual. The one who remains aloof in spite of the world, the divine. That's your nature. Essentially, you are that. Recognize. So here, Arjuna is recognizing. It has not become his experience yet. He is recognizing it. These are all the various stages of sadhana. All the chapters. Then he says, once I went to my teacher and something had happened. I was with some organization. After that, I left and I went to him. And he got up after the operation. I was taking him for a walk. And when I took him for a walk, I told him the news. Swamiji, this has happened. He says, now don't get attached to me. He says, get attached to the Lord. Lord alone will bring the right teacher in your life. Lord alone will bring the right teacher in your life. Whatever is needed for you to evolve, he will bring. But hold on to the Lord. Because you hold on to a teacher, you will find fault in him also, or in her also. Just like once the children reach teenage, till then, mummy, 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 daddy, 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 teenage. Mummy, you leave me at the corner of the road, don't come with me to the school. Leave me there. They don't want you to come. How can you come like this in front of all my friends? You're not made your hair, what funny, funny dresses you're wearing. See? So hold on to the Lord. No master worth his salt will ever ask you to hold on to him. Every master says the same thing. Hold on to the Lord. Because it is natural, a default process in us. Whatever you become familiar with, you start finding faults in it or with it. Whether it is husband and wife, whether it is child and parents, whether it is you as children and your parents, you keep looking for. You're not happy with what is there. You want more. So he says, in the 13th chapter of Bhagavad Gita will be Kshetra Kshetrajna Vibhaga Yoga. Kshetra is the field, is the prakriti, is the matter. Kshetrajna is the one who is the intelligent principle functioning through that matter. So if we take these two, everything is a relationship. So if there is a husband, then there has to be a wife. You cannot have only one single bachelor called husband. You cannot have it. If there is a child, there must be a father and mother. See? Similarly, Kshetra, if there is a field, there must be a knower of the field. Alright? If there is a field, there must be a knower of the field. But the Lord is neither the field nor the knower of the field. He is beyond both. Yet, both of them have come out of him only. The material that has gone into making the field, the world, is the Lord. The material that has gone into making the knower of the field is also the Lord, is the Lord material only. So, remember the 9th chapter, the Lord said, the whole world is in me, I alone manifest as the whole world, yet I am independent of the world. This is what Arjuna wants to know. Oh Lord, how have you manifested the whole world out of yourself? And yet you are aloof to the whole world. Yet you have not got entangled yourself in the whole world. What is this secret? We create something and we get caught up. I'm not even created. I just got in legacy. I got my grandfather, my cousins, my brothers, my mother, etc. And I get so attached to them. But how come you created the whole creation and you are not attached? This is the question of Arjuna. Because the Lord has manifested on the planet that time as Sri Krishna. How come he is aloof? He's doing all the roles perfectly. He does the role of the son also perfectly, friend also, charioteer also. Every role he is doing perfectly. Of the enemy also. But he is not attached to any role. Why? Because he is ever abiding in his own essence. But this is the question of Arjuna. So, O Purushottama, here he says, Swayamevatman Atmanam Vetham Tvam Purushottama Purusha Uttama Bhuta Bhavana Bhutesha Deva Deva Jagatpate. See, Uttama, Uttara Uttama, these are the relatives. Ut is the Kshara Purusha. Kshara Purusha is the individual, is the Kshara Purusha. Uttara, Uttara, Ut means great, Uttara is even greater. Uttara is Akshara Purusha. Akshara means that which is beyond the words. Akshara. But Uttama, Purushottama, Uttama is the bestest. And what is that? That which is beyond the good and the better. That which is beyond the individual and the one who has become free of individuality. Meaning, otherwise, gods. Some people are seen that way. Some gods are seen that way. They are not in the same limitation like an individual is. But Purushottama, he is ever free. Never has a moment come, even if he manifests in this world in different times of different periods of time, he is still ever free. Whether he comes as Ram, whether he comes as Krishna, whether he comes as Buddha, whether he comes as Parshuram, whether he comes as Narasimha Avatar, whatever role he comes as, manifestation, he is ever free. But then we see Ram crying, we see Parashuram going and killing everyone on the planet. That's a role that he had to play at that particular time. Continuing in the 16th verse, he says, Vaktur marhasya sheshena divyahyatma vibhutayah yabhir vibhutir lokanim. Lokaha nimanstam vyapyatishthasi. So here now, having come to this conclusion, if you have seen the whole train of thought, Arjuna is recognizing the potentiality of the power and his inability to come to know the Lord. But a deep yearning that I must have the experience of the divine. And towards that he has said, scriptures cannot talk about you, gods cannot know you, the demons cannot know you, only you can know yourself, and I want to know how you have created the creation and not got caught up in the creation. So here he says, in this particular verse, in the 16th verse, he says, pray tell me in full your divine manifestations by which manifestations you remain pervading in this world. If you are the whole world, if we use the word vibhu, the word is vibhu, all pervasive. How do you know it is all pervasive? You can say the space is all pervasive on the earth, isn't it? In this, it's pervading the sky, it is pervading the earth, it is pervading the air, it is pervading the fire, it is pervading the water. But can you see space? Can you see space? Can't. But you know space is there. Because without space, air, fire, water, earth, and resultant beings and things, they could never appear, isn't it? So base of the entire physical universe, the thing that which accommodates the whole universe is the space. But can you see space? Can you see space? Then what do you see? Then how do you know? My question is this. Then how do you know space?
Effect. Effect of space.
Is
known.
What is the effect of space? Accommodation is the effect of space. It accommodates the whole world. So it was the whole world is accommodated somewhere. That somewhere we call it space. So is there space between me and the book? Is there space between me and the camera? Is there space between camera and people sitting there? There is space. But you can't see anything. Then how do you know there is something? But can you see?
See, this is the language problem.
You say there is nothing. How can you see nothing?
I said, because
no, but you cannot see nothing. No thing, nothing. How? Nobody has seen emptiness. And where is your attention? Your attention is on this form and this form. The gap between two forms, you take it to be the space. The gap between this camera and the people there, you take, your attention is on the forms. The gap between the forms is taken as the space. The gap between the thoughts is taken as the space. The gap between the in-breath and the out-breath is taken as the empty space. That is the place to catch it. See? But still, how do you experience it? You have to just accept that I am because the space is there. Then what is the entirety of the space? What is the scope of this space? I have to take my attention away from all the forms and not allow my mind to come to any conclusion with regards to space, isn't it? Right or wrong? If my mind gets caught up in this form and this form, I will come to know about you, but I will not come to know about space. Even though you both are in space, 99.9% of you are nothing but space. In science also, each atom is made up of electrons, neutrons, and protons. But the total mass of electrons, neutrons, and protons is only 0.00000001. That's it. Then what is rest of it? 99.999999999999% empty space. If you take our solar system, the sun and all the nine planets, plus all the moons and everything, and if you take the space that is it's occupying, you'll find the total mass of all the heavenly bodies, the planets and the sun, is minuscule compared to the total space, compared to the space that it is, that is holding it. Minuscule. This is the same thing is told in our Bhakti Shastra. The Lord says the entire creation is like a mere pinpoint dot on the right toenail of my foot. That means it's insignificant. But where is our attention all the time? On the form. From the Lord's point of view, that form, the whole creation is form only. How much space is it occupying? One tiny pin, as much space as a pin dot pinpoint can take, that much. And how big is the Lord? Infinite. where are we all caught up? Only in the forms, only in the world. And how much space is it, are all the entire world occupying in our being? Only that much. Only that much we have given it so much importance. See? And Arjuna has understood this. He wants to transform. He wants to change his vision. He has realized that only by his grace I will have this vision. And at this moment he is at the point where he is working it out, of course, with faith, devotion and everything. He is working. Well, it's a natural question that to any seeker it will come, that how did Lord create the whole world, manifest the whole world out of him, and then he manifests himself in that world, but he never forgets who he is. And he never forgets. You manifest the dream world, you take a role in the dream, but there you experience the dream, but you don't know in the dream that you are not the dreamer. Isn't it? Some event in the dream wakes you up, then you give zero value to the dream. But Lord is giving zero value to every experience, every moment of his existence. Why? His attention is always on his own essential nature. He knows everything is me alone. How do I come to know this? Arjuna's problem, our problem, our goal, our destination. How do I come to a disposition that, like the gopis saw Krishna everywhere, how can I see the infinite Lord in and through every experience? Because I'm tired of taking ownership. I'm tired of maintaining relations. Tired of maintaining relations. I want one relationship which will never end. Husband and wife come together. One day wife will go or husband will go. You will be alone. You may have spent 20, 30, 40, 50 years ago together. And it will bring pain. It will bring you a sense of loss. Swamiji, you don't know us. Don't you? But we want, Arjuna has come to realize, I want a relationship which never ends. And that relationship, if you talk it from yoga point of view, it is with your own essential nature, self. And here, in the language of after meditation and going to Nirvikalpa Samadhi, enough, go ahead. This is where you go ahead. Nirvikalpa Samadhi is on the seat of meditation. After that, you have to expand and take the whole world to be the expression of the divine. Otherwise, I am realized, I am in Samadhi, I am realized. After we come out, oh, I think, why this world is such a problem? They can't even let me meditate also for some time. If these type of thoughts are there, big problem. Still duality is there. World, I am devotee of the Lord, you are unfortunate beings. Come, I will show you the way. You see all these characters around. So don't get caught up in anything. Hold on to the Lord. So here he says, pray tell me in full your divine manifestations. By which manifestations you alone remain pervading this world. See, our problem is, the whole world is there. It is the expression of the divine alone. Lord alone himself is expressing as the world. But are you seeing the Lord in the world? Are you seeing the Lord in the world? You don't. So Arjuna is saying, how do I catch you, man? In the world, how do I catch you? Intellectually, I am understanding that you have manifested as this whole world. But in this world, how do I catch you? Where do I see you? How do I experience you in this world? Because my experience will be with these people, right? If all these people who are here. Like, how do I take them to be divine? How do I take this world to be divine? Jnaneshwar Maharaj says, Zi tujiya vibhuti aghaviya parivyapiti shakti divyajiya tiya apuliya davaviya apanamaz jihi vibhuti aya samasta lokante vyapuni ahasi ananda tiya pradhana namankita prakatakari. He says, O Lord, show me some of your divine, all-pervasive and patent manifestations. O infinite God, tell me some of your well-known and principal manifestations by which you have remained pervading this world. These are the principles. See, our Newton discovered the manifestation of the divine. What was that? Gravity. It's a principle. It's a law. It is functional. In 99.9% places, it is functional, whether on earth or outside the earth. The whole solar system is, gravity is there of the sun and the various planets, which is keeping in the, them in the loop, isn't it? You are able to sit here because of the gravity. So was gravity not there before Newton found it, discovered it? It was there. So what did he do? He developed a vision to recognize the manifestation of the divine as gravity. Einstein discovered the manifestation of the divine, that everything in this creation becomes manifest and unmanifest. Manifest and manifest. E is equal to mc square. That when mass gets destroyed, it only gets converted into energy. When energy condenses, it becomes mass. Nothing is lost. If the water coagulates, comes together, freezes, it will become ice. Ice melts, mass gone, form gone, it becomes water. Energy, air comes together, it becomes a tornado. The tornado dissolves, if the air is still there, formless. See? So here he's saying, show, tell me, reveal me some of your patents. People put all the patents, no? In the government, copyright patents. He said, show me your patents. We'll just do one more verse and then we'll conclude. He says in the 17th verse, Katham vidyamaham yogin stvam tada sada parichintayan keshu keshu cha bhaveshu chintyosi bhagavan maya. Katham vidyamaham yogin stvam tada sada parichintayan. How may I, katham vidyam aham, I aham, how katham may know you, Vidyama. How do I come to know you, O Lord? Yogin Swam. And which, who is this you? The yogi, the one who is completely integrated, the one who knows himself as he is. Sada parichintayan. How must I need to meditate? How do I need to contemplate? On what must I contemplate? In 6th chapter it was told, Uddharet Atmana, meditate on yourself. It is, you can catch self, somewhere you will come. But here now, from the self, he wants to know the total. So he says, how do I come to catch you in this world? How do I meditate upon you? Chintayan. How may I know you, O yogi? How do I constantly meditate upon you? In what particular aspects are you to be meditated upon, O blessed Lord? Please give me some indication. People say, every master you go to, every ashram you go to, every sampradaya you go to, they will tell you, do this, do that, do this, do that, do this, do that, do this, do that. By practicing yoga, one advantage, you don't need to go anywhere. Once your personality through pranayama and japa starts getting integrated, all the questions, the right question will come to your mind that needs to be asked in order for you to go further. And if you are patient enough and continue the practice, the answer also follows the question. Because the Lord starts guiding you from within. See, this is the beauty. So you don't have to depend on anyone. Yet, till this itch is there, we must go to satsangs, we must go to meet the masters to see what possibilities are we not exposing ourselves to. See? So here, Gnaneshwar Maharaj says, Ji kaise miyav zhanave, kaya zhano ni sada chintave, zari tu chi mano aghave, dari chintan chi na ghade, mano ni magas bhava jaise, apule sangitale tuva uddeshe, ata vistaro ni taise, ekaved bole, jaya jaya bhava chi athai, तूते चिंतिता मस साया सुनाही तो विवल करुनी देही योगु आपुला. He says, O Lord, how do I know you and meditate upon you? If it is said you dwell everywhere, then no meditation is possible. What I was telling you, how to meditate on space, come difficult. If you are everywhere, how is it? Therefore, whatever manifestations you had talked about before, repeat them to me in greater detail. Explain your yoga very clearly so that I can meditate upon it without effort. In the 8th chapter, in the 9th chapter, he had given some indicate, some 15 pointers he had given. Then in 9th chapter also something. So he's saying, Oh Lord, I'm not saying it. Don't get mad with me. I'm asking same questions again. No, you only had told me. But I am still confused as to how to meditate upon. Tell me in more detail. Why you should tell me in more detail? Because I love hearing your sound. It's the divine nectar. We never get tired of listening to children's blabber when they are just learning how to talk, isn't it? It's so sweet. Mother never gets tired. She'll say, Mama, 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 Mama. Even if she scolds her, still inside her, there is still love for that baby. It never becomes less. And if she doesn't say mama, then why has she not called me mama? Isn't it? Now you expect the same way here. Arjuna, being a devotee that he is in love with the Lord as the true nature of the Lord is slowly gelling in him now. So naturally, as it is gelling, he is getting more and more concentrated upon the Lord. He is not interested in the world. The armies are doing, let them go to hell. Who cares? For right now, Lord is in front of me. This is the opportunity for me to merge into him. See? And when, like this, Swami Anuhananji, we were walking in Auckland, and he says, Yaar, tum, everywhere you come and you listen to me talking again and again and again, I give the, some of the examples are the same. Don't you get bored? He's asking me. Don't you get bored listening to me? You sit there with wide eyes and listening to me all the time. What is it that you are getting? I said, Swamiji, you will not understand. He will not understand. He just smiled. So I told this to one of my friends in Bombay. He said, kya matlab that Swamiji will not understand? I said, does sun understand what it is giving to the people, heat and light? Yeah, it should understand. I said, no. Sun doesn't know that it has got heat and light. Sun doesn't know that it has removed darkness by its appearance. Because in his, what his nature is, how can you know your nature? It is not separate to you. I told you, no, I can know you, you are separate to me. But what I am, how can I know? I am that I am. So sun, the sun, if you remove heat and light, then sun will be called sun. Not possible. The sun is heat and light. Those who are not the sun, they say, So when you interact with Guru Maharaj or the Lord with love, they will say these type of things. But what is your disposition? That's when you become available. That type of disposition has to be maintained. And with this, he again in the 18th verse says, which we'll do in next class, Vistarenatmano Yogam Vibhuti. Vibhutim cha janardana bhoya kathaya truptirhi shrunvato nasti memrutam. Tell me again in detail your creative power, yoga, and your manifestations, O oppressor of the foes, for while hearing your ambrosial words, I feel no satiety, I don't get contented, I want to hear more and more and more. What this is again, it sounds very simple, but the material in which to expand is quite a bit. So we'll talk about it in our next class. Om Purnamada Purnamidam Purnat Purnamudachyate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha.
Hari Om.